Thank you. Aloha, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Morris Paivo.
And I am Ava Ignacio.
Welcome to YKL High School's 2022 May Day program, entitled Kamuhoi Nalo, The Lost Twins.
Our hoike will commence shortly.
Once upon a time, there were two ali'i who harnessed the power of earth and wind. Their powers only worked when they were together. Their names were Naupaka and Uluwalu. They were twins and ruled all of the people throughout the land. The land and community thrived. Naupaka had the ability to grow food, create mountains, and make valleys. Uluwalu, on the other hand, could move clouds and rain, so the people had bright and sunny days and water for their plants. The people favored Naupaka for attending to many of their needs, making Uluwalu jealous. Causing greed to stir in Uluwalu's heart, he became so angry that he used his power to create a storm that demolished the community. Seeing this, it was decided that Uluwalu needed to be punished and was banished from the land in order to keep the safety of the people. With all of this jealousy inside, Uluwalu fled to the ocean, turning to a monster named Aumiki. Being that Naupaka was now alone, no longer with any powers, being away from her sibling, she takes a look at her kingdom and was heartbroken by the loss of her brother and neglect of her community.
Thank you.
On the night of the Akua moon, there was a raging storm. The winds knocked against every house in the village, while the earth shook with a quivering growl. During this storm, a mother was giving birth to her beautiful twins, Kilihau and Orama.
Thank you.
newborn babies laid against their mother, safe from the cold with the warmth from their father's arms, the girls slept to the calming voice of their mother's lullaby.
Tutu pays a visit to her newborn Mo'opuna and speaks of the prophecy that the twins are born upon. She tells the parents that the two daughters were destined to rule the islands. She spoke of the power that the two girls held, a power unlike any other. She told them that with this power comes danger. Many people are filled with greed and will want to take this for themselves.
Out of concern, the mother asks, what is best for the girls? Tutu suggested that they should be separated to be safe.
In celebration of the news that Tutu spoke of regarding the prophecy, the village throws a party for the birth of the two destined ali'i. The community showered the family with gifts, songs, and dances.
Amigi comes to see what the celebration was all about. Just like Tutu, Amigi also sensed power between the twins. From the depths of the ocean, rose Amigi. He followed the trail that the power gave off, which led to the village where Kilihau and Lorama had just been born.
Amigi felt a rush from the familiar sense of power and made it his plan to take what was once stolen from him. He watched as the twins' grandmother left and made his move to steal the power from the sleeping babies. He was so close to harnessing it all, but the baby's parents saw what was happening and stood in the line of fire.
Amigi was unsuccessful in taking the baby's powers, but succeeded in taking the life from their parents. Tutu came back to see what Amigi had done, and quickly took the girls, saving both from Amigi's grasp. The royal guardians grabbed the twins while Tutu distracted Amigi. Just like Tutu had mentioned before, it was decided that the two babies be separated so that Amigi could not sense their powers. Both guardians would protect the girls from Amigi's deceitful plans, but the only thing is that the girls were never to find out about each other. Never knowing that they had a sister, never knowing that they had a twin. The twins were left to grow apart by the caregivers as their parents.
Later.
Kiliha was taking a walk by the river when the necklace around her neck lost its hold. The pendant fell to the ground where it opened on impact. Out of the pendant fell a map leading to an unfamiliar place. Curious, Kiliha runs home with the map in her hands all the way to her parents' house. She shows her dad the map and the broken pendant and questions him on what it all meant. Upset and not convinced about her father's response, Kiliha took the map and set off, jumping into a boat, taking a voyage to an unfamiliar place. Dancing and singing, simply celebrating together, the songs reminded her of something familiar, as if she had been here before.
Yeah.
closer. Until all of a sudden, she heard a tune. It was a tune she held dearly. In fact, it was her mother's lullaby.
Kahio kamanovai o.
Thank you.
girls were oblivious to the fact that they were twins, but couldn't ignore the obvious connection. Clueless to the dangers of their binded magic, the girls decided to embark on a journey together, finding the different places in the lullaby and map that they shared. They end up at a beautiful waterfall.
After adventuring all day, the girls were enjoying the sunset until one of them heard a... until one of them heard a voice.
She's lying to you.
Ho'oponiponi o kini hao ina oi! Was Almiki. There was not much time to explain, but a monster was coming, and they needed to be prepared. The girls were conflicted when learning this, but delivered her due to the comforting presence she gave off. In order to rid themselves of the negative energy that was causing conflict, they called to their ancestors to guide them.
Thank you.
and the Watutu said, and remembered that they needed to work together in order to defeat the monster.
After defeating Almiki, Tutu wakes up from her unconsciousness and smiles when she sees that the girls have worked together. Tutu decides to tell them a story.
On a night where the moon is full, the wind sings a howling tune. A storm will brew, but not for long. Only when a mother will give birth to two, with great gifts like a pair that came before them. But only when together, their people will flourish. If they are to be separated, they will know when each other is near, for a light will shine bright like stars in the night.
These leaders were said to hold the power of all elements, water, fire, wind, and earth, and they would use these powers to protect themselves and provide for their people. These exceptional leaders are you, Kilihau and Orama, but you two weren't the first to hold this power. Long before you were born, Almiki and I were the first to hold the power of earth and air. We were siblings too. This was until Almiki decided that he wanted to use this power to control the people rather than help them. That was when I gave up our powers for the safety of the people. Then the power was born into the two of you, but stronger. That is why Almiki tried to hurt you, to take the power from you.
To show their appreciation for their tutu, the twins thanked her with a song.
Yeah.
understanding the prophecy and the events that occurred between Tutu and Almiki, the twin sisters agreed and promised each other to work together for the sake of the people. They used their power to lead and bring the community together as one, while knowing how strong their powers are when together. They believe that the love for each other is not to be lost to selfishness.
Thank you.
Please remain standing while we will sing our school's alma mater.